Hello everyone, this is Yonex here and welcome back to a new MapleStory guide. Today I want to talk about traits. Traits, as you can see, are the ones here. So your ambition, empathy, insight, willpower, diligence and charm. The max level you can get them to is 100, which I have for three of them. And it actually takes quite a while to level them. Ambition will give you ignore monster defense. So it's pretty much ignore def ignore. So if you look at ignore def, it will calculate with this one. For the rest, you get better mode attack. We don't really have PvP anymore, so that one is quite useless. And you lose less XP when you die. That's always good, but the only places you really die are Arcarium, where you lose XP, and Hard Healer. Unless you die in another place, which barely happens. So then we have Empathy, which raises your MP. On max level, that is 2k MP. And my Empathy is my lowest one. And you get a small buff duration at max level, that is 10%. Then we have Insight. I believe Insight is actually the hardest one to level, although Empathy is quite hard to level as well. The rest is sincere, quite easy, or not a problem at all. Then we have Insight, which gives small buff to accuracy and affordability. Not really important. And it gives ignore elemental resistance, really good for the end game bosses, just to do that extra damage on them. Since you need ignore elemental to do as much damage as possible. And perception rank 1. So not everyone knows what that means. You have here the glasses to like unreveal. So rank 1 means that you can unreveal for 0 mesos if it's equipped up to level 30, I believe. So I don't, this equip is a higher level, so that doesn't work. If I got my insight to level 60 or 80 and 100, then that ranks up my perception rank, meaning I can, it will get cost me less mazes to unreveal potential. In the later run, if you cube a lot, it can save a lot of mazes. Then we have willpower, probably the most important one in my opinion. Small buff to defense, that's not a big part, but 2k HP, always useful. But the main thing is status resist 20, which is equal to 20% status resistance. And since you want for some bosses 100% status resistance, this is really helpful. Depending on the job, if you want to max it, but at some jobs, when you have it at level 25, you can already max your status resistant bosses when using pot and your link skill. So really important. Then we have diligence. Diligence is by far the easiest to level, since if you just make your ores to plates and stuff like that and crafting, you level your diligence. And also if you level up smithing, accessory crafting and alchemy, you level diligence. So double mastery chance 20%. This me actually that is quite useful, but not that big thing. It pretty much means that if you get 20 diligence, for example, and it has a chance to double, you can get another 20 diligence at the same time. But yeah, approximately not that often. So scroll success rate 10%. This is quite important, since if you have the special event scrolls or premium scrolls, or we had the 90% weapon scrolls, which with this makes it 100%. Also, you have a guild skill, which helps with that as well, which gives another little boost. Although it says excludes special scrolls. Special scrolls are, for example, spell traces, so it doesn't work with them. And a couple other where it doesn't work with. But the main one is Spell Tracers, Innocent Scrolls, Epic Pot, all potential scrolls. And then we have Charm. Charm is actually only important really to level 30, since you unlock your pocket slot there, and since pocket slot is extra range, so for your pink holy cup. And for the rest, if you level it further, like 35, 40, every 5 level you get an smiley, or how you want to call it, or emoticon. So it can be nice, but for the rest, for the game wise, it's more appearance than anything else. So a good way to level your insight is mining. So you see 5 insight here. Then we have here the purple herbs that levels your empathy like this and gives you junipers. Might as well be more important. Then there is another important one. You want to level your herbalism and mining. Herbalism gives you empathy and mining gives you willpower. So if you level those, you can get your willpower instantly to like level 15 already. And then for some jobs where you only want level 25 for your status resist, that's easily done then. And you can get your alchemy, smithing or accessory craft to level 10 and then level it up to 11 or 12. If you then downrank it again and then uprank it right away, you get a lot of boost. So that's a good way as well. Then there are some other ways as well which can help you. So let's just go quickly to the map I want to. And that's Monster Park. So if you do a Monster Park run, you get the coins. I can show you the coins here. Monster Park commemorative cone. And with this cone you can buy a mustache or autographs. Autograph is good to level all a little bit. However, this works in your pocket slot, so you need to have at least level 30 charm, otherwise you can't use it. Mustache is quite good to level your ambition and charm. So it's a good way to get your charm to level 30 quickly. Just collecting a lot of Monster Park coins and then you can do that. Also by doing Monster Park coins, you get these bots. So empathy one, this is ambition minus max, so I don't get anything from it. And sanitize is diligence, but the other pots you get as well. Give all 5 points to your trade. It's the same pots you get from events. So we have here the firepower cases, those can give the pots as well. In the past we had some other events as well, depending on what events are running. You can get more pots from that. So that's a good way. If you sometimes have the shop at Root Abyss Boss, those pots give 30 to your trade, so that's a little bit more. And for the rest, yeah, the other ways to increase your trades is you can do some PQs. Dragon Rider is always good for willpower, and I believe Romeo and Juliet is good for charm. But yeah, most of those PQs, not many people do PQs, so you have kind of need to arrange a Twitter party to do them. But it's an extra good way to level them. One thing you have to take in consideration, your max on a day you can get is 500, except charm, where you can get 5000. Oh yeah, here it says /0 because mine is maxed. But if you check empathy, 500 max, and inside 500 as well, this should be 0 and 0 too because they are maxed. So yeah, charm is 5000, but NX items, if you like to buy NX your outfit, does work too. Other way for getting charm is Sarkum helmets, Chaos Sarkum helmet, Root Abyss helmet, and Haunter and Chaos Haunter necklace. And you even can fuse some Sarkum helmets to get a new helmet with new charm. Be sure to use your equip first, get your charm, and then fuse it after. So yeah, that's another way to get charm. So I think I explained it quite a bit. Thank you all for listening. I hope you learned something from it. And we will be back next time with a new guide for MapleStory. I'm not sure which one yet, but when I worked it out, you will see it. So thank you all for watching and listening. And I hope to see you in the next one. Goodbye. Thank you.